Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name's Al Ladd for Set Play Gaming. This is the Gran Turismo 7 Let's Play series, and we're doing today the Japanese front engine, front wheel sports cars from menu book number 5 in our Gran Turismo series. We're here at the cafe. You can see on the menu book we have the Honda Civic Type R and the Integra Type R, both collectible in this menu book item. We have already completed one of them, which is the Suzuki Swift Sport. This isn't like something that we've done behind the scenes either. This was actually done in one of the Let's Play videos. So I'm just by default, one of the three cars is at least ticked off. This makes things a little bit easier in terms of being able to complete the menu book. I don't know whether that was intentional, but I'm pretty sure the Suzuki Swift was something we won. So it's sort of like rolled into, one challenge is rolled into the other, so to speak. So you can see that the two gold wheels, one's on the high-speed ring track, the other is on the Suzuka circuit. We're going to do this one first, I think, simply because we haven't raced at this venue before. It should be good fun to try it out. Now this one's three laps, and I think we're going to stick with the Swift Sport from this model, from this race. We should have enough in us. You can see that the first, second, and third prize will gain the car that we need. One of the cars from the menu book, there it is. The Honda Civic is the one that we get from this race. And so we'll give this a bash. Now, the races themselves have actually become a lot more competitive. And obviously, I would have thought that, but I did change the difficulty to a more intermediate driving level. So it means really, like, if I have a better car, then I should be able to advance fairly quickly. But if the car is around the similar sort of power and performance, then it's going to make the races more competitive. You'll notice that's why I didn't pick anything above the Suzuki Swift, because I wanted to give this a good old college try first and see how I get on. Now, if I don't manage to get top three here in this race, that's okay. I can come back and try it again with a different car, but anything first or second or third is good enough. Slid out a little bit there. So you'll notice, like I said, the races aren't as clear cut as they were before. I've moved myself into sixth place. If there is anything in the Let's Play series for Gran Turismo 7 that you'd like to see me add into the videos, please do let me know. Leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you think. What can be improved, that kind of stuff. We just try and pass these guys here. Hi guys, how you doing? Right, so we are fourth, and we have one more lap to do this in. It's quite a short circuit, this, isn't it? Just slow down a bit here. We do have a little bit of room to catch up on that third. I don't think we're gonna get it first, but we might be able to get second. I'm running out of time though here, running out of track. Let's just get round this, see if we can negotiate past this third place. It's that Brazilian guy, Fraga, who's ahead of us. And then we've got two Japanese drivers ahead of us. We get Fraga on this corner here. I don't think we're going to even get second here. I'm going to have to make our move. And then once we're done here, we'll head over to the high speed ring. And I know we've played that twice now in episode 4 and, I'm trying to think, episode 5 was it? Is this episode 6? Episode 6, yeah. So episode 4 and 5 of the high speed ring. Here we go. Final lap. So we should be able to take him. We might be able to get second. So we're going to go and head over to that track once this one's done. And just try and take him here on the outside. Well, he's got a little bit of power in this. I think his is a Civic, isn't it, that he's in? Yeah, that's what it looks like anyway. Seems to have a little bit more power than control on those corners than we do. This thing seems intent on sliding out every time we get to the corner. And we are being guided somewhat by the marker below that suggests which gear to take each corner in. It's saying second there. I think we can take that in third. This one will be second. We're running out of room again now. We need to take him. Otherwise, we're going to lose this. Get in there. And I'm going to take him here on this last corner. On the final lap. We just about managed to squeak home in third. So, probably need a faster car there just to try and get a top spot. But it's okay. Third still gets us what we want. And I'll take it. I'm focused right now on advancement more than anything. And because there's so many cars, I don't need to mess around trying to get first in everything. At least I don't think so anyway. Unless there's going to be some bonus at the end for getting first in every race. But the ultimate aim here at the minute is to complete the menu books and advance in the car collection. And we're doing that. We're doing a good job. So the next one is the Integra. What's that? Collector level's up to 4 now. The tuning shop is now open and we can access the club sports menu. So head over here to the high speed ring and you can see there's a new one that's opened up for the FF challenge. And it says road cars only and the performance points up to 450. So we could just switch over to this one. This one's performance points 437. It's got a little bit more power to it as well. So we got 2 laps. Let's see how we get on in this one. And we're going to get the Honda Integra if we get top 3 here. So again, the main aim is to just advance as quickly as we can. I'm wondering as well, like, what happens in, like, another 10 menu books or 12 menu books. I still haven't uncovered any of this part of the world circuit yet. And each time I do a menu book, I'm uncovering new tracks. And then I will use those new tracks. I will go out and do like time trial. And then I don't, as I mentioned in the last episode, I don't just do a time trial with one car. I try all the cars out that I have in my garage. I take them out for a spin. And I see sort of like, I start off with the lowest one first, which is quite brutal at times, but I like to sort of race around and see what times I can get in each car. That actually goes towards the marathon points as well. And again, I'm not sure what happens when you complete the marathon or whether it's just an aesthetic thing to go for, like a completist thing to go for at the end. But there's still other tracks that I've not unlocked yet. And I know there's been some updates on Gran Turismo 7. So I'll be looking at those keenly over the next coming weeks. We just try and take this one into fourth. And we still have another lap. So there's 2 laps of this circuit. We're quite familiar with this circuit because, like I said, in episode 4 and 5, if you want to go back and watch those, that helps me a lot on the channel due to watch time and things like that. It supports me. I'm going to be doing this a while. Like, I'm going to be doing Gran Turismo for a while because, like I said, there's over 400 cars to collect. So I can't imagine that every single one is going to be, winnable through race only. Like, you literally, like, every car is unlocked through races. It does seem a bit pointless. I think there's going to be some cars that are still going to be locked through credits. And obviously, you're going to have to race certain races to get more credits so that you can then go out and buy those cars. So that's going to be interesting to see which ones are available in the races and which ones are outside of those races. There are a lot of cars that I've seen. They are, from a credits point of view, they are like 1.5 million, 2 million, 3 million credits, I think, is the most I've seen. So when I think that it's taken me like nearly 6 or 7 episodes just to get to like 200 and something thousand credits. That's amazing, the grind that you're going to have to go through just to get to 3 million. Even off camera hours, just racing those races is going to take a long time. Obviously, as the more prestigious races come up, you know, they're going to award you way more credits. Like, I can see some races that are on there now, they're like first place is 70,000. So you only have to race that a couple of times and you're already at nearly like, you know, 500,000. You know, you only race it a couple of times and you're already at 500,000. So I think as you get into higher class races and higher class vehicles, obviously 70,000 isn't going to be the ceiling. You're going to end up with a way more competition prize money as well. So this looks like we're going to get third again here. Yeah, third. So two third place finishes today. Not ideal, but considering it's the first time that we race a Suzuka circuit, you know, and we don't want to be on beginner all the time. And like I said, since like last two episodes, I think it's been, I've changed it from beginner to intermediate. So the races are far more equal now. I'm not just blowing by absolutely everybody. Maybe the first four or five starting positions, but once I get into the top three, you can see that it's a little harder for me to breach those final few spots. So we complete the Japanese sports cars from the menu book. We'll head back to the cafe, and hopefully we should have a completed item there to do. 192,000 credits. That's right, because I purchased another car. I'll have to show that in the next episode. Make sure somebody reminds me to show you that, otherwise I'll forget. There we go, it's a nice nighttime evening shot. Luca, congratulations, you've got all three cars. Once you've collected your rods, I've got some stories to tell you about the cards. We've got a roulette ticket. That usually means we get some extra coins as well, so you can get... The roulette ticket gives you extra coins. Sometimes it can land on car parts and cars. Even cars, you can win cars there. But I've never won anything but coins so far. The front tyres need to steer the car and provide drive cornering efficiently requires a bit of accelerator work. On the plus side, cars make much better use of space than rear-wheel drive cars and require for fewer components. Layouts are used in all types of cars, mostly compacts, and tend to save for novices because they... A few sports covered up FF layout, particularly from Japan. Honda has produced lots of FF sports models, naturally with aspirated engines, starting with the Civic RS in 72. These models include DC2 Integra Type R and Civic Type R, which are very popular to this day. Actually quite fun to race as well. I've actually took the Integra out off camera, obviously. And yeah, it's been fun to complete this one. So the next one is tune a classic car. That should be fairly straightforward. No racing on that one. We'll be doing that in the next episode. Alright, that's it from me today. I hope you enjoyed watching this episode of the Gran Turismo 7 Let's Play series. I'm going to endeavour to try and get the next episode out on Friday for you. And that's going to be menu book 6, which is tuning the car. And if it's not that long, we might jump into the next menu book item as well. So if you enjoyed this, consider watching more content from the playlist available at the end of this video. Until then, this is Arlad for Set Play Gaming. See you guys real soon. Have a nice week.